all good to go. I think we're all set.
What is that again?
That's as soon as you get up to that level, you get minus one XP for killing minor monsters. They count less as you go on. Let's see here. I think we're live, everybody. Hey, thanks for joining us today. We're going to do a live playthrough of Masmorra, Dungeons of Arcadia by CMON. I'm Doug. This is, of course, Sydney. We're Victory Condition, and my brother, Tom. Let's say hi, Tom.
Hi.
All right. we're Victory Condition Gaming because winning shouldn't be the only victory condition when you get to the table. We're excited. We're actually backers of Masmorra. We got a copy to review of Masmorra, and thanks to a wonderful gentleman at Gen Con, and we're here to stream it out and let you all know. We did put a review video up for Masmorra. It was a little mixed, but we're hoping that maybe this video will help you answer a little bit of questions. We also had, I will admit, before we did our first couple playthroughs, when I knew that we had a copy coming, I actually read the rule book for the early release rule book, which had changed a little bit. So we played with those old rules. So the rules have changed slightly from, and luckily we found that out, and hopefully we'll be playing correctly tonight. And you can see for yourself whether or not this is going to be a game that you'll like. We're big fans of CMON. We love their products, and we're excited to get going on this. I just want to make sure that there's nobody in the chat. Let's see here.
Everybody just wants to can you please stop talking? We just want to watch you play the game.
I know, right? I just want to make sure that there's nobody that's to join us via the chat. If you have any questions, even if you have any questions while you're watching this on YouTube, because we will be exporting this stream to YouTube, if you have any questions, feel free to put them down in the comments below. I do try to stay up to date on the questions. We just love communicating and hanging out with gamers, so if we can help you in any way, we're more than happy to. Let's see if we have... All right, so I am in the chat. All right, so now let's get started. I am playing as Jay. Jay is this warrior guy. And he has this ability where he can use any symbol as a shield. That's pretty neat.
And a coin.
And he gets a shield and a coin. I'm sorry. He gets a shield and a coin for any symbol ability. What Sydney is playing as Mika. Mika looks like a little like rogue type figure.
She is a human and rogue.
And I just gotta say that these figures are great. If you like Arcadia Quest, they are just as good as the original Arcadia Quest figures. Kumani knows how to make some great chibi figures. Mika's ability is what? You may use one of your action die as a symbol you need to disarm traps or opening treasure cards. So that's kind of where her rogue ability comes in. Tom is playing as requested by he's playing Greybark.
Greybark, with you can exchange your free foot token for a shield, a sword, or
an elixir.
You
actually played him through our playthrough, and he was quite handy.
That was good.
We all start out on this middle tile, and then we're going to expand the dungeon out. As we move along, we've got two sets of tiles here. We've got level one and the big rooms. We've got level two and the big rooms. The first player to get to 16 XP, we finish that round, and whoever has the most XP at the end of that round will win. I've got the first player token. Everybody has these little tokens right here that indicate a free movement. There are 2 points of movement if you need it.
And the first player token looks really cool.
It does. It looks like a little torch with a skull on it. And everybody is given 2 treasure cards at the start of your turn.
We know what they are, so.
All right, so I'm going to go first, if that's okay.
Yep. Because you have the first player marker, that makes sense. got the first player marker, you win.
So I got two.
Go last.
Two. I've got a. I got a whole bunch of walk and an elixir and a sword and a bow. I'm going to.
Ooh.
Yeah, I like that a lot. Let's actually. I'm going to trade this sword and shield. Every character has the ability to trade a sword and a shield in for a sword, a shield and two swords. So that's what
so
I'm going to do for that.
You get just an extra sword.
Probably
going
to want to move first, though.
Let's do that. We're going to move first. So I'm going to use that.
Wait, should we flip that over?
Oh, yes. Yeah, so we need. You always need to flip over. This is one thing that... Oh, we're not going to use that. This is one thing that we...
I just heard something.
What's that?
We're like, do-do-do.
We're going to use that for, that's one thing that we forget, sorry, I kind of lost track. That's one thing that we kind of forget to do, is you always want to have that first tile, flipped over. In our review, it was kind of one of the things that we didn't really like, but we'll play it through for you. You guys can make that determination for yourselves. You don't have to play it that way if you don't want to. That's just, what we thought. All right, so... I'm actually going to move down here.
Okay.
This is a well of health.
Doo-doo!
And I could use a sword.
You mean a shield?
A shield to get two elixir tokens. But now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use my second movement and move down here.
Doo-doo!
And that automatically puts a coin right there. Ooh. And, oh, that's a big... It rolls a minor monster. Tom, do you want to roll a minor monster for us?
Here we go. A minor monster coming.
It is a ghoul. He goes right there in the corner. A ghoul is a 3 attack, 3 defense, and he also has the ability that he steals 1 foot die, movement die, if available. If not, he steals the foot token, which we don't, which I don't have. But
yeah, you do. You have the foot token. Oh, wait.
No, I don't.
Oh, yeah.
So what I'm going to do is I actually have 3 bows. Since this guy has 3 defense, my 3 bows are going to act as a ranged attack. So this ghoul is not going to attack me. I'm going to be able to attack it and take it right off. How many XP do I get for that?
For a ghoul, you get 3 XP.
So we have a little XP tracker. So I get 1, 2, 3.
Ta-da!
And since I leveled up, I get to choose one of my... abilities.
Well, go on to the next row.
Since I went to the next row, I actually get to move up one of my abilities.
Ta-da!
And it's going to preemptive strike. That's
a
one.
A sword equals 2 bows.
A sword equals 2 bows. So I can use 2 swords, or I can use a sword and I'll get 2 bows back.
Cool.
The token in the room?
Nope. I have to unlock the treasure chest.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Oh,
that's
but right. I do. Yep, that's right.
Oh, you also get an experience for unlocking the
treasure chest. Yep. So I'm going to use this die
Ta-da!
To get the coin. If you get so many coins, you get 5 coins, you can buy 8 treasure chests as well.
You mean a treasure?
Treasure cards as well. So I'm going to take this treasure.
Well, wait, Dad, you didn't get 5 coins.
No, I didn't, but I opened the treasure chest. And
oh, yeah.
Since I opened the treasure chest, I also get 1 XP.
In fact, never mind.
And now, I have 2 die left over. I can just cash those in for 2 coins.
Ka-ching!
Ching, ching. All right, and everybody has 6 XP, health, and now Sydney.
It's my turn.
It is your turn.
The turn you dread most in a game. Your turn.
Make it a good one.
Ooh, that is a good one.
I don't know what's good and what's not.
Well, you can always
move.
You don't really need this at first. The other thing that you can do is you can actually move and then roll your dice if you wanted to, because that's what this is for. You have 2 points of movement. But I guess it could help where your strategy, but
no. I'm just gonna re-roll this.
Okay.
Just put it in.
Okay.
Cool.
All right, so now
you... Did you see that? It was like...
Yeah, I saw that. So now you can either use your two movement points to move up here and then go off of here, or whatever you're going to go into is going to be a big room.
And you get 1 XP for it?
And you get one XP point for it.
Wait, is that a room, or does that
represent? It signifies a big room.
Oh, okay.
Oh, so no matter what you go into, even point. Thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate that.
That's two, three.
All right. Oh, this looks like a nasty room here. Here, we're going to put that just...
You want to set this side, ends up with these, right? So this isn't sealed off?
That's how it goes, yeah.
All right, so we got three...
So you got three monsters in there. Three minor monsters and a major monster. Oh, wait, no, it's an eyeball.
It's an eyeball. What is it called? It's called a...
A dark watcher.
The other ones are called a cultist.
Now, here's the thing. Since you explored that room, you automatically get one XP.
Yay!
Okay? But now you've got to fight these guys.
I do?
Yep.
Why?
So, you can change... you may use one of your action die as a symbol you need to disarm...
Traps.
Oh, traps. So you can't do that. Okay.
But she does have two bow.
But you do have two bow. You could take out... This person right
that
here.
That guy.
For nothing.
No, can I
for
take
nothing.
The one that's away from, like, that's closest to me?
Yeah, oh, sure, sure. You can take out this guy.
Thank you.
Okay, with your two bow.
Ta-da!
So we're going to put them there.
Well,
then,
you want to get the experience for it, probably.
Wait.
Because she'll be able
to... She steals one... and the cultist... There's three cultists and one... what is this? The
Dark Watcher.
The cultist steals one elixir die. If not able to, it steals one elixir symbol. The Dark Watcher can't use any abilities while in a room with a Dark Watcher, so you can't use any of the abilities.
I do want to point out that she's going to gain 2 XP from killing that, right?
Right.
So she's going to get an ability before she has to worry about killing anybody else, right?
Right.
Okay.
So, we're going to do that. You get 2 XP for that. One, two, and now, are you...
This one. Bow equals a bow
and, two coins. Okay.
It's basically just like, why can't you just add like bow equals.
So you could even kill one of the other guys, but they would attack back for 2 hit points.
Yep. Well, they're gonna attack back anyway.
Right.
So
you might as well eliminate one.
So what do you want to do? You want to eliminate another one?
Sure. To attack. One of these.
Okay, so we'll take out that one.
Sure.
Now, I'm trying to see. I thought that when you take out a monster, that was one thing that we didn't do right, is when you take out a monster, you get the XP. Do you also get a treasure card?
No.
I'm trying to remember.
I don't think.
First, now I looked it up earlier, and now I forget what it said.
Well.
Okay, so keep going.
Well, you put these on your used dice there.
So you've taken up. So you're all the way up there.
So you still have your feet. You can trade.
Wait. So let's resolve the combat from this one first.
All right.
So she's gonna fight back.
Okay.
One, two.
Who is she?
Yep, the one that you just took out.
How does it fight back? It's dead.
Because you didn't do a ranged attack with it.
And then you gotta do two more for this one.
Yep.
So bring that down two. And then you've gotta do three for this one.
Three.
Yep.
Which will take you out.
Yay!
Okay, so now...
I'm sleeping.
So now what happens is you reset all the way back down to your current level, and Uncle Tom gets to take one of your treasure cards. Now I'm trying to see if...
Here, let me shuffle. Just switching them back and forth.
I'm trying to remember if you get a treasure card for taking out a monster. Oh, whoop, you know, okay. Okay. Then, you don't get it. You get
a monster.
Yeah.
So rude.
I discard it?
Yeah.
Or put it back on the bottom of the deck.
Well, you're supposed to just discard it. But
okay, so
if we run out of treasure cards, you reshuffle.
I did, now everybody is.
Booked at it. You're so rude.
Sorry.
Alright.
I looked at mine too.
So now, since you're KO'd.
Wait, don't I need to flip this over?
Yep, flip that over. So that's a spawn point.
For
so
monsters.
Now, what you have is you have two dice here.
Yeah.
You can cash those in for gold, I think. Oh, no, your play immediately ends. So,
okay,
that's that.
Wait.
Yeah, okay. Now it's up to Tom. But wait a minute. We also have two movement points that we can spend.
Okay.
So, Sydney, since it's your turn, where would you like to move? Would you like to move one monster twice, or would you like to move both monsters once?
I'll move each monster once.
Okay, where would you like to move them? Awesome. Okay.
Alright,
so now it's Uncle Tom's turn.
Alright.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
It's a gift.
Yeah, it is.
Keep that.
Oh, we should have probably gotten the dice tray out, shouldn't we?
Probably.
Yeah, that's alright.
Do I need to go get my dice tray upstairs?
No, not right now. Well, there's a dice tray down below if you want to go.
Ooh.
Hey, Spiral Mind! How are you today? Thanks for joining us! That's kind of big. I don't know if we...
You wanted to get the dice tray out.
Okay, yeah, that's good.
So I'm going to use my two movement. I'm going to use one here.
Okay. So now you have to immediately...
There's my two bow.
Okay. Actually, at the start of combat...
Actually, I'm not going to use that. I'm going to use this.
Okay. So that'll take care of that.
Yeah.
So you get the 2 XP for...
Killing. Yeah. I still have one more movement, right?
Nope. If you only use one movement point, that's all you can move.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Oh. Okay.
Unless you have another foot icon.
Alright. Well, then... There goes that plan. I guess I'll have to get... 6 tokens. Or 6... Because I can't do anything with these. Or I can... I don't know. Yeah. Yep, that's all I can do.
Okay.
So I'll cash one in to get a treasure, I guess.
Okay.
Since I'll be getting 6 of them.
Alright, so now it is my turn.
Your turn!
I can have my foot ability again. Oh, you know what? Let's actually roll that in...
The dice tray
like we have.
It's not sitting there, you're not using it.
Okay, I don't like it. I like this. I'm going to save that shield, and then I'm actually going to reroll all of our shots for this. Okay, well, I got lots of shields.
Well, it gives you extra protection.
Okay.
Against the...
So here's the thing.
Big guy.
I'm going to combat that. He does 3 attack.
You have 3 shields.
So, nothing's gonna happen, right?
Yeah, because I don't have anything to... So, but I can use the 3 shield.
You can use one shield for a shield with a coin, if you wanted to, and get a coin out of it.
Yeah, I could do that. So let's do that. So I'm gonna use my shield to get a shield and a coin. And I can't defeat that guy. So I only have...
Wait a second, where does it say you get a shield and a...
Right there, that's my starting ability.
Oh, okay.
So I have three things left over, which I cannot use. I am just going to cash them in for 3 coins.
Cash in 5
And then get 5, then I'm going to take 5 and get a treasure card. Alright. So, Sydney, it is your turn. Now, here's the thing.
I'm dead.
You revive. Okay. Now.
Do you get all your life back?
Yep, you need to get all your life back.
It's like the beginning of the game again.
Yep. Hey, Billy M! I'm watching with my 8-year-old daughter who also can't wait for our Masmorra Kickstarter ride. Thanks for getting Grey Bark into the game. You're welcome. I'm glad that we could do it for you. And I'm glad you could make it, because I was hoping that you'd be able to join us and we could answer any questions for you. I think our review was a little harsh for this game after the fact. I think it's a little bit more fun. It definitely plays really fast. You seem to level up a lot quicker than you would in Arcadia Bus, which is fine. It's good. Billy M, where are you from? Okay. So, right now, you could move in here.
Yeah.
And you're not going to be able to take him out, though.
I want to try a different room.
You're probably going to want to try a different room.
Now, do you immediately spawn creatures in the spawn point, or do you wait until...
Yes, you immediately spawn... You immediately put a creature in there, because that's what that little skull token, that little skull icon is.
So it's either this monster or a weaker monster. And you don't have a lot of attack, really.
I have.
You can turn a bow into a bow and two coins.
You're just basically just getting two coins.
Right. It's up to you, whatever you want to do.
I have an idea.
Sure.
It's going to be really, really, really dumb, though.
What's that?
Da 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 da!
Okay, you're gonna move right back into there.
You actually got it.
Yeah. So that's your movement icon.
That would be really.
And one die, right?
I win.
Nope, because it counts as two movement points.
So she has all her die.
So now you have all your. So what would you like to do?
I don't know.
You can go into another room if you want.
No. What's
that? You can collect 6 coins for all your, or you can technically use this to get 2 coins. And then use these to get 5, get a card.
Yeah, why don't you do that?
Okay.
So we're going to throw that there. You're going to get 2 coins.
Then you can
cash these 5 into 5 for 5 coins,
nine
and you'll actually
seven.
Get a treasure card. Well, if you, and then you pay 5 to get a treasure card. All right.
My turn?
Your turn now.
You want to hand me that other die?
Yep, you sure can.
So, I think...
From the beautiful country... County of Gloucester, England. Oh, excellent. Well, I'm glad that you were able to join us today. Did you also back Inferno? We're very excited for Inferno. I mean, we're kind of bummed that it keeps getting pushed back, but that's fine. We've got plenty of other games to play and that we feature on our channel. But we're really excited about Inferno. We also back Massive Darkness, too. CMON seems to get all of our money, as they do with a lot of people. Massive Darkness looks really cool. We're really excited about that one. I like Zombicide Black Plague, so I'm hoping that Massive Darkness will be right up there with that one, too.
I think that's where I'm going to see you. He defends 4.
4, yeah.
1, 2... So I'm gonna go.
Okay. 1.
1 right here. Right
okay. There. So there's gonna go there. And we gotta reroll. We gotta roll a minor monster for him. Gonna roll it in the dice tray.
The monster dungeon.
Yeah. All right. So it is Is that a goblin?
No.
It's an orc. He is a 3 attack, 2 defense.
Okay.
Which is good because you could probably take.
You kill him into attack.
Yeah.
But yeah. So it's alright. So we're going to use this in combination for 2 swords and a shield.
Okay.
So
basically
2 attack and a defense.
Sword.
Okay, so that's going to.
That's going to kill him. I'm going to use this for another defense.
Okay.
So that's 2 defense out of the 3, so I will take 1 hit.
Okay. And how many XP do you get for taking out the orc? 2?
2.
So you level up.
Room card.
1, 2.
next room.
Oh, nice. Thank you. And you get an ability.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So I have 3 left. I will use this to heal 1.
Okay.
And then these 2. I'd like to... What color am I? Alright.
You and I are tied at the moment.
I'm right behind you guys.
I should look at my...
I think I'm going to cash in these for 2. 2 gold.
Okay.
And that would be good.
Alright, so now it is the GM turn. So this, since this is a spawn point, you want to roll for...
Yeah, I'm in here though.
Oh, yep, never mind, thank you. Since there's a hero there, if there's a hero or a monster in a spawn point, they don't spawn. Thank you very much for reminding me on that, Tom.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to now roll my dice, and hopefully I can take out this watcher. Okay, no. So I like these shields.
Shields are good.
I'm going
They're
to now...
They're good.
Actually, you know what? I'm going to re-roll... Ugh.
Yay.
Nothing.
You're welcome, Dad.
Attack. Get rid of that guy.
I need to get some swords because his abilities are all swords. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to trade this into a shield and a coin.
You're welcome.
Yeah, 3 shields.
And so I'll have 3 shields, so I won't take any damage from him.
But you only have...
But I only have 2 bows to take out his 4 defense with.
You don't want it.
And I can't do anything. So I got to trade these in for...
Some coins?
Some coins.
You just cash in.
And then I'm going to buy... you can only have up to, what is it, 4 treasure cards?
5, I think. I think it was 5.
Was it 5?
How many cards do you have?
I have 4. So, we'll say I have... Take one more time.
It's 5. They might want to double check, though.
So there's that. Okay. Billy M says, he backed Inferno 2. Excellent. And he's piggybacking with a local guy to save on the shipping. Smart move. If it's going to England, then yeah, it's, I can imagine it must be a little pricey.
I have a question about this. Why does that have a dotted line, and why does that have a line?
Just to show that it... That's what they go.
Is it different for like a 3 or 4 player? Is the dotted line something else for like a?
I don't think so.
Varying on how many players you have.
I don't think so. I'd have to look it up. But anyway, Sydney, it is now your turn. Your dice. Flip your little one. You got a lot of potions, a lot of shields.
We don't really need those. You don't really need that.
I would say save 2 shields and then re-roll the rest. But you kind of want some swords if you're gonna go into that next room.
In the treasure room. There's 1 sword.
There's 1 sword.
And a foot.
And a foot.
There's foots.
Okay. So now what are you gonna do? You can trade the sword and the shield in for 2 swords and a shield.
Okay.
So you're gonna use your foot token?
So you're gonna use your foot token.
Wait a second, that doesn't make sense.
It's just a wall, you can't get out of here.
I know, but it makes sense that, like, wouldn't it not make sense in a dungeon if you open a door and you're like, oh, there's a wall there. Like, that doesn't make sense.
So now we've got to re-roll, we got to roll a minor monster.
So much. It's an orc.
So it's only got 2 defense.
Her,
but no, she used it for 2 combat. So you can use the 2 combat.
2 combat?
Yeah, because you got 2 combat here, the 2 swords.
And you use that shield.
And you can use that shield. So you're only going to take 1 damage.
Do, 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 do.
Okay, but you get, how much did you get for defeating Orc?
2.
One, two. And you could go keep going if you wanted to, if you wanted to move into another.
I don't know if Chu wants to move with only two magic die.
Or you could try to unlock that.
Oh, what's the next one?
Oh, yeah, you gotta. Oh, it's a trap! So a trap is going to go.
You scream
right here.
Oh my gosh!
So actually, that. You take another.
What? I'm not even in the room!
Can you
I know,
put
but.
That in?
No, you have to do both of them.
Yeah, it goes through the room.
It goes to any of the adjacent rooms.
So right now it's going to hit these rooms and this room.
Yeah, unless somebody can disarm it.
I do have a thing that says use.
You have to be in an adjacent room to disarm?
Use one of your action dice.
Oh, you could. You spend one of your action dice, any symbol you need to disarm a trap. So you could spend
use two
this,
of those.
And, no,
I
you could
use two magics in case you want to move again.
No, so you can only use one of your action die to any as any symbol.
Die as.
So you may use one of your action dice.
Oh, okay.
So you could change this to a potion.
And that, keep that as
and dock that, and that's going to disarm the trap.
Dun, dun, dun.
Okay.
And then you get how much? How much experience is the
you
trap?
You say it's a trap.
The trap is two, isn't it?
Two.
Yep, two dots, yep. So
you say it's a trap, but don't worry.
Oh,
my
and
gosh.
She gets an
one,
upgrade.
Two, so now you get another upgrade. You could have also moved that one up if you wanted to.
No.
All right.
And one gold?
And one gold for cashing in that one. That was a good turn, Sydney.
You're a good turn. I'm funny. No, I'm not. That didn't make any sense. I'm sorry.
Oh. What we got?
Got a lot of stuff.
I don't really like this. I'm getting hung up with this beholder guy.
It's not a beholder.
What is it?
The Dark Watcher.
Dark Watcher. Sorry, it looks like a beholder to me.
You should call it an eyeball. Call it a floating eyeball. That stares at you. And looks into your soul.
That's going to be one, two.
Oh, plus you got an early bird. So Billy M got an early bird on Inferno. Lucky. We tried to get it. We got shut out on that one. We did get an early bird for Masmorra, though. And he's getting pets. We are also getting pets. We are also getting the dragons. We're really excited. I'm really excited about the dragons. Sydney's really excited about pets.
I'm going to use my movement die to move two.
Okay,
then I'm going to fight that guy. I'm going to use this to do two swords and a shield. I need three attack, though, so I'm going to use... I'm actually going to use one of these. So now I have three attack. I have one shield.
Okay, but we need four attack to defeat him.
I do need four attack?
Yeah, because he's got four shield.
Okay.
Okay. So he's going to do three damage back to you because you
right.
Cannot do
well, one. I have
okay.
One of it.
So that's
I can
two.
Block two of it.
That's one.
And I'm going to take one.
All right.
But he's gone and he gives me four experience.
What?
Yep, because I'm not higher on the track yet.
One, two, three, four. No, that's just for minor monsters.
Oh, so you better. So I get a new ability?
So you get a new ability.
Wolf Companion.
All right, so grab that Wolf Companion, put him right on your little card there.
The other thing I would like to do is steal one XP from a hero in the same room as me. Thanks, Doug.
All right.
Wait, doesn't he?
Did you put me up?
One.
What's that?
You didn't put me up one, though?
No. It didn't say you get one. It just says steal one. No, I'm just kidding. I didn't take it. Mm-hmm. All right, and that's it?
Yes,
I am going to
keep it for yourself.
Play this.
What does it say?
Teleport yourself to any previously explored room in the dungeon.
Okay.
I'm going to go right back here.
To block the...
Block the spawn point.
Okay. I see how you're playing.
And I'm pretty sure is that all my dice? No, I got two dice. Do I want to move? That's probably a very bad idea. There's a spider in the next room. What does the spider get? Two attack. You need four attack to kill it.
And that web stops moving, so...
I am going to get two gold and then cash in my five.
Okay.
For another card.
How many cards do you have? Oh, you just moved up. That's right. Okay, so now it's my turn. There's a hero in here, so no, that's a spawn point. So yeah, we're good. Okay, it's about time I got some swords. Some swords, a shield, and now I'm gonna actually do that again. Okay, another shield and a heal. Okay.
Ultimate turn here.
Now it is my
You can get two ranged off your sword, that's nice too.
Yeah, but I need to
change that to a shield if you need to.
So let's move. I'm gonna move into this square right here. And immediately it's a web.
Immediately can't move, right?
And you can't move. And we need to place a
spider.
Spider has 2 attack, ooh, 4 defense, and heroes can't leave a room with any spiders except for teleportation. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this sword and shield into 2 swords and 1 shield.
You probably want one of these, right?
I am then going to trade 1 die. Sword die into 2 arrows.
It's the 4 attack you need.
So that's the 4 attack I need.
You need 2 defense, you only have 1 defense, right?
So I have
you need 1 more defense.
1 defense there, and then I'm going to change this one.
I already have a defense over there.
Yep.
So that's the 2 you need. You just put it on your
board. Oh, okay, yep.
So you already have the 2 you need. Why don't you put the shield on the shield and the coin, get a coin.
Yep. You're right, sorry. And we're going to defeat him. I move up 3, 1, 2, 3, and let me just make sure I got everything in here that I want to do. Okay, I think that's, because I have the maximum amount of cards anyway. I'm gonna cash these in for 2 coins, and now it is Sydney's turn.
Sydney just needs a sword to
so
get
yeah,
more
why don't you, why, and you get an XP for opening one of the treasure chests.
And a coin.
Oh, don't forget you need.
Yay!
So you probably don't want those. You probably want these.
Let's see here. Haha, I ended up getting pecs specifically for my daughters. Yes, right. That's exactly, as soon as they announced it, I showed Sydney, because Sydney and I were really excited about Infernal when the Kickstarter was going on, and as soon as they announced it, Sydney squealed, she thought it was awesome. So, I'm right there with you, with pets. Tried to get the Fire Dragon, but increased postage by $30! Wow.
There you go.
Yikes.
So yeah, you want to use that
but
sword?
At least you get the poison dragon for free. That's true, and they're not exclusive. The dragons aren't going
to
be exclusive, except for the
three.
Poison one. So hopefully you'll be able to pick them up locally once they get over there.
Experience. She opened that treasure.
Oh, nice.
While you were updating.
So what would you like to do now? So did you use your?
She hasn't moved her movement token.
So you need to move. You can move if you want and try to take on whatever spawns in this spawn room. Why not? You got enough. You got shields and everything. You can trade one of these bows into a bow and 2 coins. You can trade this into.
Show that right there.
Yeah. Why don't you trade that into 2? And you got a heal? Yeah. Oh yeah. I'd go on to your next room.
Well, first off, you can use that heal if you want.
Oh yeah. Why don't you use this to heal up?
And then you can take it out of hit point.
Out of hit point. So you're back up to 5.
Then you can move wherever.
Move right here.
Let me in.
Okay. So now we're going to spawn a minor monster. It is a skeleton. A skeleton you can actually use. See what it says. Skeleton, it is immune from bow damage. But it can use elixirs as ranged attacks.
All she has is range.
So all you have is range.
But she can block.
But why don't you, Argentberry,
Agentberry?
Oh, hey, Billy-M, thank you so much for the follow on Twitch.
If you use the foot, you can defend the attack at least and get 2 coins.
Okay.
So there's that. Whoops. So that'll give you 2 coins and keep you from getting killed.
And keep you from getting killed.
And you need to attack, but you can't
and
use
like
the bow.
And I'd like to buy a treasure card, please.
Okay. Do you have anything in your treasure cards that can help you with the skeleton?
Wait, how many do you need to
Five.
Five. Okay.
And six.
So do you have anything in there that can help you with your... Because all you got is bows, which don't do you any good. I mean, you can use a bow to get two coins. If you need to. Because she has that ability, it just won't help you with the attack.
William, what other games do you guys play? Being a dad and having a daughter that's close to Sydney's age, we find a whole lot... We try to feature games that are close to you know, her level on this on our Twitch channel and on our YouTube channel. Tom, of course, has a daughter who is... How old is she now?
12.
Oh, 12. And time goes by way so fast. Way too fast. So we try to keep, you know, games that are pretty close to that for to help parents introduce their kids to the hobby. But, yeah, we always like to hear what other games... parents are playing.
Okay, so maybe you want to get two coins for that, and then two more coins for that.
So you're going to get four coins?
So you can get another card if you want.
Do you have five? Do you have five coins?
So you're about to give her four.
Yep.
Do you want another card?
Yay!
Now maybe you can use that one. I bet you won't want any dice. So, can I get the dice from you there, Sydney?
I almost thought you could only have four treasure
well,
cards.
Well, we kind of started with five now.
Yeah, I know.
But it might be four. If it's four, just play with one less.
Yeah.
I mean, there are bigger groups you can make than
playing
capacity.
Yeah, I know I looked it up and I forget what it... I tried to reread the rule book.
Oh, I get this die now, right?
You do. But you know what? I'm actually going to play this. And it says, the chosen player rolls minus one die during this turn.
All right.
That's for stealing one of my XP, by the way.
Alright. No, I understand.
Revenge!
So I'm gonna keep one of these.
That's why I stay in the middle of, like... That's why I don't use my treasure cards that much. Because I don't want to do that. Like, here's your revenge! Stab!
Ah! Myth looks fun. It does look fun. That's what the Spiral Mind says. Billy M says, we play a lot of Chaos Ball. You can see my written match reports with pictures on the session section of Chaos Ball, the Board Game Geek page. Actually, I think I have seen your reports because we looked at Chaos Ball. I looked at it like a little while ago because I was interested in it. And I did. I actually enjoyed those reports quite a bit. I'll have to check that section out a little more again.
One.
You get minus.
I don't have a foot though.
Foot. Okay.
So I still have one more movement point. No, I'm gonna play this. Steal one XP from a hero in the same room as you.
Oh my god!
But it was revenge.
This is double revenge. It's revenge on the person.
And now you want to know. Now you're wondering why our review wasn't. Wasn't glowing as Arcadia Quest.
So now we're going to move our one more space down here.
Okay. I'm going to reroll a minor monster.
Stick to my strategy. Don't use any of your
so
treasure
it's a skeleton.
Cards unless you absolutely
need to. You can't use any ranged attacks with it.
That's all right. I'm going to use this combination to do two attack and one defense. I only need one more defense.
So you're going to take one damage?
Let me think here. So this is also two attack and one defense. So I'm going to do that instead. And then I'm going to use this defense. So that's exactly what I need to kill it.
That's right. Chaos Ball is another CMON game. I forget.
So that's one more experience. Do I get anything for killing them? No.
Nope.
And I don't have...
I do think you get a coin for killing him. I think now that's what it was. Because they have some sort of loot on them. But let me just look it back up again.
Either way, I can't do a whole heck of a lot with just two ranged die. Yeah, I don't know if I'm gonna get. Either way, I'm gonna use these to get two, because that's all I got left.
You cannot take a heal action until after all combat is resolved.
Okay, well...
By the way.
Well, I didn't get hurt that combat anyway. But that's good to know. Small things like that help.
Okay, so now we have to... Now it's the GM turn. This guy is going to spawn. Yeah. Spawn... it is a hag?
No.
What is it?
It's a cultist.
Cultist, sorry.
Look
and
at
now they
the
have this one has two movement points. Where do you want to move it, Sydney?
What?
Where do you want to move the cultist?
You can move this one. You can move this one twice.
Okay.
There you go, Dad.
So now what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna have your little minions die back.
There you go. Like, oh, you defeated the Dark Watcher? Nice. Here's another gift.
Ugh.
Right behind you. You could give those potions to me.
I've got nothing
one.
I can do.
You could
Another really cows?
Dad, you can move.
Well, I'm still looking.
You can change your walk to a shield if you had to move. Oh, you automatically lose one of these in that room, don't you?
Right.
So
let's
that's
move
gone.
On. That's gone.
And you're going to want
to
use your foot token to move.
Use my foot token to move one.
Other than you just flipped it up.
Oh, sorry. And then, see, this guy kind of revolves around getting swords, and I haven't gotten any swords.
Wait, next.
And then.
Oh, we had a trap next room.
Oh, we did. Okay.
So that should have gone.
That should have gone
right here.
Yep, you put it right there. So technically, you should take one ex-
that,
take
that's
one
fine.
One damage.
That's
revenge. No, just kidding. Here, I'll move
that
up
room?
For the next room.
Yeah, we need the next room flipped here.
So I'm gonna take one damage since there's a trap in there, and it's adjacent to that room, and.
Okay.
I really can't do anything. I think what I want to do is I'm going to move into this.
So, you're gonna
so I think I take another damage from moving
out
of.
Do you?
Yep. I think anytime you move in or out of it. Now spawn that, and hopefully we get like a skeleton, right? The skeleton.
Nope.
What is it? An orc?
Yep.
Ah.
There's also a gift, right?
But you'll get, but since you're on the lower track, you will get the full XP.
What's that?
Since you're on the lower track, you will get
yeah.
two XP.
Oh, yeah, that's
one.
Great. What is that? That's an orc?
Yeah.
And no special abilities.
That's good. That aspect. Downside is how do you kill him?
I don't think I can.
So you're
going to So I'm going to move one of these. I'm going to move this to a shield and a... coin.
Okay, so that prevents one out of three damage.
Okay, so I get take two damage.
Then you're
gonna. Then I'm gonna heal up
three. Back where you were.
And then I'm going to cast these in for.
You don't have five guys already?
I have one, two, three, I have four.
Wow.
For this one. Oh, but wait a minute.
Can you, like, not move them so I can see them?
That's okay.
Looked over at you.
I am then going to choose and remove one monster,
from the
but I don't get the XP. So okay. I'm going to take that one out. You're welcome. All right, so now...
So this monster rooms?
Now, wait a minute. Well, we got to spawn monsters first.
Okay.
There's a spawn point right there.
Who is it?
All right, it's a ghoul. So now we get to move two... It's your turn to move since I just went. So you can move either a monster
so
twice.
The ghoul is here. We're going to move this guy here.
Okay. So Sydney, it is your turn.
My turn.
See, Splendor. I'm not sure if you guys know Splendor. We play a lot of that at home, at my gaming group, and on the app, too.
Yeah,
it's a fantastic... Oh, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
Trying to...
It is
a fantastic 2-4 player game. It takes 5 minutes to learn and can be played by all ages. Highly recommended. Actually, we have the Splendor app. It's excellent.
You gotta kill this guy.
I can't
attack.
Recommend it enough. It is a
you
lot of fun.
Two bows, you can kill
and it's really well done. It's one of our favorite apps.
Does it mean to bow symbols? He's immune to both.
Is he immune to both symbols?
He is.
So I would almost reroll all of that.
Wait, that was a sword, wasn't it? Or did it?
That was magic.
Okay, so why don't you reroll all that? And all hopefully, yep. Yeah, hopefully you get another sword.
I love me.
Oh, she could have kept the feet as a two.
It's okay.
It's alright.
Right, there's
you get
it.
Okay, so you got your other sword.
My sword!
Bows don't really count.
Bows don't count, but you got the shield.
You got the shield.
And you got a heal. So, what I would do is I would use these two. What are you doing?
She will when she takes the hit.
Yeah, you can't. So are you down to five or are you down to six?
I was down to five.
You're down to five? Okay.
So you wanna use your two attack, kill it.
Use your two attack.
Bye bye.
But then you need to defend two. So here's one. So you're gonna lose another hit point.
So there's your that takes care of that. So now you're gonna use that to heal up.
Yeah.
Okay, now, wait a minute. But you get how much XP for killing that skeleton? Two? But minus one, right? Because you get
that. No, you get three minus one.
Skeleton.
It's a ghoul.
Oh, is it a ghoul?
Yeah, I'm looking right at the picture. It's a picture of a
ghoul. Oh, no. It was a skeleton because it wasn't arranged by. Yeah, skeleton.
Oh, then you get one.
One. So you get one XP like that.
Okay.
But don't I get a coin?
So the question is you can probably use this for two coins for the range.
Oh, by the way, here's the dice.
And then get one coin for that.
Oh, that's what that was. She took the die off and the ghoul was right there.
Oh, well, that's not
no,
the ghoul.
No, I didn't. It was this die.
Yeah, I know. You took the die off.
Yeah, there was a ghoul here. I thought Doug put it here. But that's fine. We're
fine.
No.
Yes, that spawned.
I picked this up, put it over here, because that's what I thought was that one.
No, I'm confused. That is my die. And that was here.
Right, but we put it on the side that was over here before.
Yeah, we're okay.
We're fine. Do you need...
It's okay.
It's okay that you're confused.
Stop it.
Do you want to get two coins?
Stop your
coins,
I'm ready.
Do you want to get two coins?
Sure.
Okay.
You can get three coins total.
Oh, yeah.
Because one, two, and then three. Even though the range doesn't do anything, she can still get the coins for it, right?
Right. Okay. So my
turn?
Now it's your turn.
You need to get some cash here.
You
do.
Do I get a... Oh, I forgot to play a card earlier.
I'm going to hang on to this. I'm going to hang on to this. I'm going to hang on to that.
Oh, wait a minute. We didn't move the monsters.
Moving the monsters.
So
and we need one of these for a spawn point.
Yep. Okay. So, Sydney, you actually get to do... Do you want to move the cultist in with Tom? Okay, and do you want to move one of these guys one?
Doesn't matter which one.
Doesn't matter which one, okay.
Does the cultist lose a hit point for coming in this room?
No, it does not.
That's exactly what I wanted to see. Okay, so we're going to use... I got to fight the monster first, right?
Yep, and this cultist steals one of these.
Yeah, that's fine. We have two attack and a shield. I don't want to. Oh, I can also roll this one.
Yep.
Oh.
Okay. Nice.
So I'm going to use this for two attack and a shield.
Okay.
And I just need one shield for that. And I will use this for my one extra shield.
Okay.
So that takes care of it. It gives me one XP.
One XP. So that brings you up to level 12.
I'll slide this out to regenerate.
Generate a new character, yep. Or a new ability.
Ability.
Do you want to disarm? Do you have any abilities? No, you can't, because you don't have any die to dock.
No, so I'm going to end up taking a hit from that.
No, it's only if you go in and out.
In and out,
yep.
Okay.
So you can...
I will do this, yeah.
Okay, so that gives you one more XP.
And I need a
treasure card. And you get a treasure card. Billy M, what other apps do you usually play on your devices? We really like Star Realms. Warriors is another one that we really like.
There's another game that we play, but it's not.
Patchwork. Patchwork is a great app. They've done a great job on that one.
I'll use this to get one health and two coins.
All right.
I will trade this in for another card.
Okay.
Don't look at got it, Dad.
So now, what would you like to do with your two, with your three?
I can move. Not the sword and shield, though.
Just remember, if you move out of there, you're going to take one hit point.
That's right. Alright, well, I think I will play
that card.
I will play this. Switch places with you.
Actually, I'm going to play this called Counterspell. It cancels the effect of another card.
Okay. Okay. So then. And then I will. If I move, I get hurt. And if I don't go into a new room, I would go in here and I'd get hurt again. So if I move two and I go there, I go into this two.
This is the
right?
Next room.
It's a portal.
And I don't have enough to defend. The next room is a portal?
Yeah.
No, you
can move
into
here. You can move
into
here.
Oh, there are, there's a bad guy in it, though.
You can always move into here.
But there's a bad guy in it. I don't want to. I don't have enough dice to kill it.
So?
Yeah.
You don't know. It could be. You could have enough to kill, like, a skeleton. Or a goblin. Or a cultist. Or an orc. There's four out of the six that you could.
Yeah, I could kill.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, we'll move.
Where are you moving?
Move over here. Oh, but wait a minute. You minus one. Minus
no,
one.
I'm using the foot to go past it. I won't have a foot die after that.
Okay. Go ahead.
So.
So now if you go in there, you can pay a magic, and
move
you can move anywhere in the...
So we'll roll this puppy.
Puppy.
Oh, it's a cultist. So she steals an elixir, which you don't have.
She?
Or he, or whatever. I
don't
know.
He.
All right. Whatever.
It has a beard.
So I will use the two attack, kill it, but I will take two damage.
Okay, but you get one X point. You get one X point.
Like...
And that's
your turn.
That's for the eyebrows.
And I will play.
What is it?
I'll play that.
It says, choose and player rolls minus one die during this turn.
Come on, you can stop it. No?
Like, you didn't even give me them all anyway.
Right here.
No, you didn't give me them all, so.
That'll work, then.
I'll tell you.
It makes you feel any better. I'm out of cards.
Doesn't make you feel any better.
Wait, what about that dice right there?
I
don't get to roll it.
Because I made him take it out.
Okay. This is the roll that I wanted to get a while ago.
There's one last time.
Okay. Oh, we didn't flip this over to see what it is. Oh, great.
Oh, my God.
It's a trap.
That's
scary. So that would give me another hit point.
That would give you another hit point.
That's fine. So it's this one. This one is a spawner.
Okay. So I'm going to... go
the next one is
into this room over here.
We're not doing this?
No. Totally
not. Not playing with those.
It's a big room.
A big room.
So I'm going to go in there.
Yeah.
You want to put
a big room?
Put a die in it?
No, leave that be.
Oh.
Want to roll it up?
Put a die in it.
Rolling it. I'm rolling it. Let's see what we'll get.
Okay, it's an orc.
An orc that has no special abilities.
That was a sword and shield. I'm going to take the sword and shield and trade it in for
That's
two swords and a shield.
You need to defend one.
I'm then going to trade this in for a...
Why are you doing all that? You don't need four attack.
I might need four attack. Oh, okay. So I'm going to trade that in for two... Okay.
Range. Now
two
you
range.
Need, now you need the two defense.
No, I don't.
Oh, no, it says you have
range,
okay.
So what do I get for defeating him?
You get two.
One, two.
And you get another ability.
And I get another ability. I'm going to do preparation, which is a foot for a sword and two coins, and...
You haven't moved yet.
No, I haven't. But knowing that big room is coming up...
You're not going to.
Fit right in here for using.
Okay, no, I'm not going right there because there's a trap right there.
Come on.
I'm going to use my movement to move right here.
Now, do you lose hit point for moving out since this was
No, it's on the adjacent rooms.
Okay.
Ready?
Ready. But turn it
over. You get one XP, Doug.
Oh!
Oh, we get a big boss.
Yeah!
You automatically get one XP, Doug.
We got Auntie Bitey.
You don't want this view?
Oh, yeah, right there.
We got Auntie Bitey. Bitsy, Auntie Bitsy.
Wait, Auntie...
What about this one?
That's means we can move on to level two. There is a token in the box. I didn't grab it.
Oh, okay. I'll get that.
Auntie Bitsy. We have to defeat her twice. She has a
blue side
where the hero loses one life at the start of combat. Red side spawns a spider at the start of combat. So spider is on the die.
It must be
it's a spider.
I don't see a spider.
There's a spider right here.
Oh, a spider right there.
It's a blue
okay.
one.
So, in this case, I'm going to do a sword and a shield for two swords and a shield. And then I'm going to then...
Three swords. So you need one more shield or you lose one.
That's okay. So I defeated this one.
The blue side, yeah.
But I also take one hit point.
And you take one from one life at the start of combat?
Oh, that's right. I take one. Yeah, you're right.
Okay, so now we go to the red. Do you get the experience for the blue side?
I do get the experience for the blue
side.
That's
three.
One, two, three.
And you get the experience for coming in the room?
I did, yeah.
Okay.
Pretty sure I did. And at this...
Did you gain your ability when you went into the room? Because you were right here last. Did you gain your ability?
Yeah, I gained my ability. Yeah, right there.
Okay, alright. I thought you gained it when you killed this guy.
I can't remember.
Anyway.
She spawns a spider at the start of combat!
So now...
Spawns a spider.
So now we need to put a spider in there. And I'm taking 2-4 damage.
Yay!
Well, it spawns at the start of combat. Are you fighting with it again?
Well, I have to attack it. Pretty much you have to attack
you
it
have
twice.
It. Yeah.
So, I'm going to do that as a shield and a coin.
So it's going to do 4 damage to you.
It's going
to
do 4 damage to me. Total. So I do 3 damage. 1, 2, 3. I'm KO'd.
Yay!
So now, Sydney, you get to take it.
Well, wait, did you... Oh, that's for combat only. Alright.
Okay, take that one.
Can I look at it?
You just discard it.
Yeah!
Oh, actually, you know what? Play during your turn. I could play this and not take 3 damage.
You're supposed to save this card till the end of the game!
But I can play that during your turn to save 2 shields.
So you're gonna do that, right?
Yep.
Doug, not looking at his cards.
No, I'm not looking at my cards. So I am still actually alive.
Wah, wah, wah.
Alright. I tell you, this is what happens when you play so many games that you kind of forget. Okay, so it's all 3 of those. We need to spawn some monsters. Sorry. Where do you want? We'll put this one right here. Put that one right there.
You can choose
and
the
now
two.
You can choose the 2 movement points if you want.
Okay.
Oh yeah, anybody that helps me win the game right now. Because if you put that monster in that room and I kill him,
this counts
it's
as
game over.
No, don't. Oh, okay. Yep, never mind.
Go ahead. No,
so this counts as
your dad. My brother.
Billy M says has to sign off. Well, thank you so much for joining us. I'm glad you could. I will definitely let you know once it uploads to YouTube. And thanks for the good luck. I think it's running out. I don't think I'm doing very well. I don't think it's going
to
end very well.
Does it have to be in between the new monsters?
No, it can be any of the monsters you want.
Yeah. Except for this one.
Okay, except for
this one.
And this one. And that room.
Okay.
Wait, that was
It's fine.
Okay, so now it's your turn.
Roll and die. And figure out what you want to do, Miss. Out in the middle of nowhere. I guess we're all kind of out in the middle of nowhere.
We are.
to do that now.
Well,
you want to move, so maybe you want
to... Wherever you move to, you're going to move down into the second level.
Yay!
Unless you want to come over here and try to take out some of the some of the easier monsters.
No.
Okay. This is our last first level room. Do you want to move into it?
Sure.
But you're going to want to
re-roll any of these?
You're probably going to want to re-roll those because they're pretty...
Useless.
Pretty useless. You might want to hang on to that for health. And these
but I can have it
good.
To be that.
These are pretty good too.
So why don't you re-roll those three?
Maybe those three?
These things?
Yeah.
Because you already got movement. You don't need the magic.
Magic.
Oh, that's a good one. That is a
and
good fight.
Use
so
this.
You want to use the... You got to save that for last.
You got to save that for last. Okay, so now...
You're gonna move.
So let's have you move.
You're gonna want this, right?
I don't want it right there. Just kidding.
So does that start a whole other level?
That starts a whole other level. So we've got to actually
restart?
Restart
your brain now.
Yeah. Do you want to move into the small dungeon? I mean to level two? Or do you wanna come out do you wanna
Am I the only one who would be in level
yes.
two?
Yes. You would be. Level 2 is harder.
I don't know what that means.
Level 2 is like the stack of tiles.
So now we can't make rooms up here, right? We can only make rooms down here.
We can only make rooms in level 2.
So does that mean everybody?
Mm-hmm. No one can go into new rooms now, I'm assuming.
We can't, right. We have to actually go through here in order to get out of this.
So the only thing that'll happen on the floor is spawning enemies and traps. So unless you go to the other floor, there won't be new rooms to explore.
Right.
This floor is explored.
Ooh, I like this dungeon. It's pretty.
Okay, so what would you like to do, honey?
Nobody disarmed those two traps.
Nope.
So if you wanted to try to...
Good
job. If you wanted to...
But you can only move two.
You can only move two, so you can only move one, two. So there's not really a whole lot... Oh, yeah.
You're almost, but if you go two down here, you're still gonna end up right here.
Well, you can go one.
I'm gonna go back to
one and then two.
You are?
Yeah. Just get
one,
Sydney.
Two. Okay.
And then you can use that to heal.
Use this to heal.
You can use this.
Oh, Sydney. There we go.
You can use this for 2 coins.
To heal.
Use that for what?
2 coins.
Use that for 2 coins.
And you can use this for 4 coins if you wanted to.
4 coins!
But you can only have so many, so you might want to cash the 5 that you have in. Or you can't.
Do you have anything in here that you can use for combat or anything?
Or movement?
Or movement?
Can you move? That would be better if you could teleport to move.
Do you have anything that gives you teleporting abilities?
If you had a teleport, it would help you out a lot. Because you have a great role.
What does adjacent mean?
It means like someone next to you.
Or next room over, usually.
Because I have an idea. Okay, I can use that later.
Please. I mean, we can say you didn't move, if that helps. But
no, okay.
No, you don't have anything?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, we're going to trade that in for four coins.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't have, how many, oh, you only have
that's
five.
A total of 9 coins. How many coins can you have?
You have as many as you want.
Oh, yeah.
Coins are actually one of the tiebreakers, so. Alright.
I win!
Oh, wait a minute. Movement points. Which way are we moving them?
Spawn points.
Oh, spawn points. Okay, so now where should I move these guys? I'm going to move this guy.
Hey.
Right there.
You're mean.
And that's all I can do. So that's 2 movement points.
Alright. My turn.
Your turn.
Okay, I'm gonna hang on to that.
Okay.
I'm gonna hang on to.
Hanging on.
I'll use this, I'll hang on to those, and I'll hang on to that, and I'll...
I can't fit there.
I know, I'm trying to think of what I want here. don't need that. I don't need that, technically. I want to reroll this.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
Okay, so what are you doing?
I'm going to use this. To move. Oh, no, I think I'm going to disarm this trap.
Okay, so it gives you 2 XP. That's 16. That ends the round. Since I'm the first player, it's going to end anyway, so.
Alright, so this is just for a little bit of fun?
Yeah, just for fun.
Just for fun.
This is where I think that I like having the first player token rotate.
Right.
Because you lost.
I'm going to move to move down here.
Okay.
I'm going to fight that puppy with my 3 range die.
The puppy? Okay, so you get 2 XP for that.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I have one of these. I've never had not known what to do with a shield before.
You can just pretty much just cash it in if you wanted to.
I'm going to use this to get a potion.
Okay.
And use the potion as... Can I do that?
No, you have to dock the die.
Okay, that's fine. We'll do it to get a life back, and we'll do this to get a coin.
All right. And that's the end of the game, because Tom, I was the first player. Everybody has had the equal amount of
turns.
I have 2 cards that I held on to. Actually, I had 4 cards that I held on to for quite a while. They give me extra XP, +2 and +1. So, +2 and +1. So I get 3 XP.
Sorry, no thanks.
Cancel it back with another card. Which one do you want to cancel?
That one.
We're bringing him back down.
Doesn't help you. It didn't prevent either one of us. How many, you don't have anything else that could have?
No, not really.
Oh, you had a swift strike though. Did you just barely get that?
Barely got over the guy.
Alright.
So once again, we made it just to the second floor.
Right.
And we didn't play any.
That seems to be a common thing where
I think it's made if you run away more often, you end up in a harder level, but it seems like you can thoroughly go through the first level every time and beat just the first level.
Yeah, it seems that like every single time we've played it so far, we've either just barely gotten to the second level.
One tile of the second floor the last time.
Yeah.
And this time, no tiles.
I think that's one of the
look at him, because we're never going to actually get to play him.
One of the kind of things that we have...
It does explain
the first card!
It does explain the fact that there's only 3 large Act 2 rooms.
That's the first card! Look at the first card!
First card would have been...
Wow.
Would have been this room.
Yeah, it would have been a major and a minor monster. And
next is a trap! Next is a monster spawn point.
Anyway... So that is our playthrough of Masmorra, Dungeons of Arcadia by CMON. Hopefully, it kind of explains to you how the game works. I'm sure we didn't get everything exactly right. This is our 3rd time playing it through. We played it through a couple times before. It's a fun game. We like it. It just seems to be... we really like Arcadia Quest. And I know people have commented, you can't really compare the two because they're 2 separate games. But since they're both in the same universe, they have the same art, it's easy to compare the two. So I
also have to say that this game is very, it does have a lot of tweaks and small adjustments for rules that you kind of have to get used to, but it's a very simplistic type game.
Right.
It's not easy to be confused playing this game.
Yeah, I think the symbols and the symbology and everything.
What's this?
That is an endless pit.
An endless pit.
I think the symbols and everything, it makes the game really easy to learn, really easy to pick up. You can get pretty much the basics down just by looking at everything. CMON did a great job doing that. The components are great. It is a fun game. I'm going to tell you that. It's a great little dungeon crawler.
I won with the most coins. I won the competition for
it's,
most
it's
coins.
A great dungeon crawler. Especially if you're not if you want to play with like younger kids, it just seems to be a lot easier to pick up and learn for them because you're not having to do so much math and have to. It is a little more fiddly than Arcadia Quest. a great game. I think everybody's going to like it. If you're a fan of Arcadia Quest, just know that it's not going to be Arcadia Quest. It's going to be a little bit different. It doesn't make it a bad game. It just doesn't make Arcadia Quest, which is a game
that is not Arcadia Quest. So, I mean...
Right. It's a game that as long as... I think if you went from Masmorra to Arcadia Quest, it wouldn't be so bad, but going from Arcadia Quest to Masmorra kind of feels like you're taking a step back.
No,
in your opinion,
are you saying this is a little more simplistic of a game than Arcadia Quest?
Yeah, I think...
When it comes rule-wise?
I think it just, like, Arcadia Quest, you've got the map in front of you, you've got boss minis, you've got scenarios and objectives you have to complete. Seems like a more immersive feel. But this is fun, and you know, you got you're building the dungeon as you go. It just, for some reason, it doesn't, and the fact that we haven't really, we've played it a few times and haven't really got to that second level is kind of concerning to at least to me. I don't know if it would be for everybody else, but it just seems
you're looking
like,
forward to the mystery of the second floor,
yeah,
and you don't really get
I mean,
to it much.
I think if you go through level one, please don't do that. If you go through level one, you can pretty much get to 16 XP pretty easily, especially if you're getting XP from all these different. You're getting XP from treasure chests. You're getting XP from defeating monsters. You're getting XP from exploring large rooms. So, and then not to mention stealing XP from other players.
Absolutely. That's one of the fun aspects.
It just seems that, like, you get a lot of XP really fast, really quickly. So getting to 16 XP is pretty easy. But anyway, that's our playthrough of Masmorra. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you didn't like this video, I'm sorry. I hope you will subscribe to the channel regardless. We do all sorts of reviews and playthroughs, especially on Twitch here. If you're watching this on YouTube, we do upload the content. You can watch us live on Twitch. I'll put the link for that down below. If you're watching this on Twitch right now, feel free to check out our YouTube channel and please subscribe. We really, pretty much, I am a dad that loves the game with my kid, and I love sharing that experience with other parents, other players, and I hope that you find our content enjoyable. I hope you find it helpful, and I really appreciate the community that we've kind of found online. So without further ado, I'm going to sign off. I'm going to say thank you very much for joining us today, and we'll see you on the next video.